Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Thomas.
Hello, little Thomas.
Salutations.
Good morning, Henry.
What's so good about it, Thomas? I feel terrible.
Really? How so?
I can't make enough steam.
Again, Henry? You said that 2 days ago.
Sometimes I can more trains. Sometimes I have no strength at all. I suffer dreadfully and no one cares.
Rubbish, Henry. You don't work hard enough.
If we can make steam, so can you. I think you're just a whiner.
Wake up, lazy bones. I arranged your coaches 10 minutes ago.
I'm sorry, Percy. I just can't seem to make steam today.
Poor engine. This has been going on for days now.
Again he does this? I have a branch line to run!
I wonder what's making him late.
Don't ask me. He went on about how he doesn't have enough steam. A lot of rubbish if you ask me.
Sorry, Thomas. My steaming problems made me late.
Stop blaming your problems on other things. How can I run my branch line if you're always late?
What is wrong with me?
Henry.
Sir.
Your driver and fireman talked to me last night.
He does try, sir. He really does.
Isn't there something you can do about it, sir? I'm sorry, Henry, but you're too expensive. We've tried giving you new parts and new paint, but it does you no good.
You mean?
If we can't make you better, Then we'll have to get another engine instead of you. Today, I will accompany you, and we'll see how you run. Driver, meet me at the big station, and I will climb aboard.
Hurry, hurry, hurry. We mustn't be late. Not like old Henry back there.
Henry's a bad steamer. See, I build up his fire, but it doesn't give enough heat. I see. And you're making the fire well. It must be something else.
We have to stop, Henry. You've no steam to go on.
I shall have to go away.
Goodbye, Henry. I do hope they are kind.
Me too, Edward. Me too.
Last time we took him to the works, they said there was nothing to replace, except for the parts you ordered. Maybe it's not Henry.
Aha! Sir, look at this. It's the coal. I beg your pardon? The coal is wrong, sir. See, the other engines can handle this type of coal. They have big fireboxes. Henry's is small and can't make the heat. I see. If this is true, Henry must try different coal. Exactly. I was thinking Welsh coal. It's high grade. With it, I think he'd be a different engine. It's expensive. But Henry deserves a fair chance. James, leave those trucks here. I want you to go fetch some high-grade Welsh coal for Henry.
Another goods train? If I must, sir.
Henry, wake up.
No, I'm not getting bricked up again.
Oh, it's you.
Feast your eyes on this, old boy. Now we'll show him, Henry, old fellow.
That's not how you usually make Henry's fire.
Well, that's because the fire's already been made. Here, I'm putting large lumps around the outside, like a wall. Now, I cover the glowing middle part with smaller lumps.
Hey, you're spoiling my fire!
Wait and see. We'll have a roaring fire just when we want it.
Suddenly it's easier to move.
Henry, how do you feel?
I feel fine.
Great. Have you a good fire?
Never better, sir, and plenty of steam.
No record breaking. Don't push him too hard.
Oh, Henry won't need pushing. I'll have to hold him back.
Hi, Gordon. Bye, Gordon.
Henry? I've never seen him so energetic.
What a run!
Henry?
Where have you been, Lazy Bones? I can't wait for a dawdling tank engine like you!
How did you get here before-
Can't stop! Goodbye!
Have you ever seen anything like it?
Well done, Henry. You have exceeded expectations. That coal is doing wonders.
Thank you, sir.
Hello, Henry. How are you?
Great. I've never felt so alive.
Alive? You haven't been alive until you pulled the express, coasting down the line at full speed.
Maybe I will someday. I have the strength now.
There's more to it than strength, Henry. You have to know all the stops and keep control at high speeds. It's not just any old job any old engine can do.
Go to sleep!
Sure thing, James.
Huh. Henry started it.
Good night, Henry. Here's to a good day tomorrow.
Good night, Edward.
Wake up, old boy. It's time.
Time? For what?
We've been entrusted with a flying kipper. A fish train. As bad as it sounds, it's very important. Besides, if we pull the kipper nicely, the fat controller will let us pull the express.
Hurrah! Whoa, there's snow and frost on these tracks.
We'd better be careful. Snow can cause accidents.
Let's go! Come on, don't be silly, don't be silly. Oh, that's better.
distant signal up. Caution.
All clear, Henry. The home signal's down. Away we go!
What? This isn't our path. I can't stop!
Henry, better hurry up. My driver and fireman are sipping cocoa in the brake van, and I'm out freezing my tender off.
The kipper is due.
Who cares? This is good cocoa.
All right, fireman, back to our engine.
But I haven't finished yet.
It'll be here when we stop again to let the Wild Nor'Western pass. Now come on.
What was that about our cocoa still being here?
Henry, are you all right? Henry, what happened?
I failed. The Fat Controller will never trust me again. I'll have to go away for sure. I'm so sorry, sir. The signal was down, so we didn't know.
Cheer up, Henry. Ice and snow caused the incident.
I suppose it's time for another trip to the works.
Yes, somewhat. You see, I've decided to send you to Crew, a fine place for sick engines. There, you shall receive a new shape and a larger firebox. This means you won't need special coal anymore. Won't that be nice?
I mean, I don't have a choice.
Poor Henry.
He was doing so well with his Welsh coal. What a way to go out.
Oh, he was just getting hot-headed anyway.
Cheer up, everyone. He's being sent to Crew, and he returned better than ever.
But what if he doesn't come back? It could have been a ploy to scrap him.
Don't say that, Percy. The Fat Controller loves his engines very much. He wouldn't scrap him, would he?
Of course he wouldn't. We just have to wait for him to come back.
Good morning, everyone!
Good morning, Henry! You look splendid!
What a transformation! They've turned you into
a London Midland and Scotland Stannier Class 5.
Ooh! Fancy! Almost as fancy as me.
Oh, knock it off! Why should he have a new shape? A shape good enough for me is good enough for him. He goes gallivanting off the Crew, leaving us to do his work. It's disgraceful.
Shut up. Just jealousy pulls the Express better than you.
That brings me on to another thing. Henry whistles far too much and is too loud. No respectable engine whistles as loud as he does. It isn't wrong, but we just don't do it.
Don't mind him, Henry. I, for one, am glad you're back. I like your whistle.
At least someone does.
Goodbye, Henry. We're glad to have you with us again, but remember what I said.
Is he right? Do I whistle too loud?
Hello, Henry. Why the quiet whistle?
Gordon says that no respectable engine whistles as loudly as I do.
Don't take notice. He's just jealous. He thinks no engine should be famous but him. Whistle as loud as you want. See? Nothing to be ashamed of.
I guess. It does feel nice to, but what's that?
It sounds like Gordon. And it ought to be Gordon. But Gordon never whistles like that. Oh, well, well, well.
There's so much for it isn't wrong, but we just don't do it.
Let's see, I'll have two chocolate, one glazed, and how about, oh my, am I the only one who hears that? Take him away, and stop that noise!
Oh, the indignity. What will Henry say?
It isn't wrong, but we just don't do it.
All right. Let's settle down. Tomorrow the day will be cold. Stay warm, everyone.
At least he didn't mention whistles.
No one tells me anything. How am I supposed to work while I'm freezing?
It'll be alright, Percy. You got a warm fire, don't you?
Yes, but my funnel is freezing. I want those things Driver puts around his neck.
You mean a scarf?
Yes, a scarf. I want a scarf.
But Percy, engines don't wear scarves.
Engines with proper funnels do, but what would you know? You've only got a small one.
My funnel's not that bad. I'm quite proud of it, actually. They gave it a nice polished crew.
Engines don't wear scars. Oh, on his couches. Now for some fun. Why did it have to be jam?
Because we were planning on a picnic lunch today, Percy. Look at this mess.
Yes, sir. I am, sir.
We have to pay the passengers for those spoiled clothes, and my trousers are ruined. All because you wanted to play Grandmother's Steps with the coaches.
Oh dear, Percy. What a mess you have made. Well, on the bright side, you got us scoffed after all. Poor Percy. Shouldn't have been mucking around. I'm just lucky something unfortunate hasn't happened to me today. Hello! Ow! My boiler!
Oh dear. They've broken the carriage windows.
And they've chipped my paint. It's a shame.
Call the police!
Hold on. I know what we're going to do. We're going to have Henry sneeze at those boys.
Huh?
Henry draws in air through his fire and puffs it out with steam. Puffing hard, ash flies into his smoke box like a blocked nose. I can make the air and steam blow the ashes out.
I never agreed to that.
Come on, old boy. We'll do it on the return trip. Henry has plenty of ashes. Please keep all windows shut until we have passed the bridge.
There they are, and they have the stones.
All right, Henry. Sneeze hard when I tell you. Now!
Achoo!
We got him! Well done, Henry. They will drop another stone on us again.
But my paint is black as soot.
Nothing we can't polish. You'll be as good as new.
Well, Henry, I've heard about your encounter with the boys. And about your sneeze.
It was my idea, sir. They dropped stones on us, and I wanted to pay them out.
There are better ways to handle this situation. And tit for tat is not one of those ways. Next time something like this happens, you let me know.
Yes, sir. Henry, your paintwork. What happened?
Oh, I just had a little sneeze.
A little?
But I taught some naughty boys a lesson about dropping stones on me.
There you go, Henry. Show them who's boss.
Gordon, please.
I can now go to sleep knowing I've even got Gordon's approval.
Remember when I yelled at you guys to go to sleep? That still applies!
Good night, everyone.
Good night, Henry.
We're glad you're back.
It's good to be back.